And welcome to a game that really should have pulses racing. Every reason to believe this will be enthralling. I'm Derek Ray, here on the commentary position, joined by Lee Dixon to help me describe all the action. And what we have coming up for you is live action from League One. It's Gillingham, and they face Hull City.
Yeah, thanks, Derek. Should be a good game, this one. I always wanted to start the game on the front foot, fast play, force the opposition to respond. Hopefully we get that from the start of this match.
Number 8, Kyle Dempsey. Number 16, Alex McDonald.
Well, here is the lineup for the hosts today. It looks pretty orthodox, Lee.
Yeah, I love this formation, 4-4-2. The two main strikers will stay close together. The full-backs will link up with the wide players. The two holding midfields will sit in front of the centre-backs. Very solid look about this team.
Well, here's how the lineup looks for Hull City. And this is a formation most people in the game are very familiar with nowadays.
Yeah, most coaches are adopting this formation. What it does give you is two holding players in front of the back four to protect them, but it also gives you three supporting players to that central striker.
Thank you. Enjoy the game.
And they kick off here. And a throw-in it's going to be. Done. Yanis Hadji. It's Weah on the ball. James. In position. Couldn't quite hang on. Well, threat averted.
Well, they simply got to play better. They can't keep conceding chances at the back. They've dodged another one. The crowd are letting them know about it as well, urging them on to try and improve themselves.
Well, as the caption shows, the visitors come into today's game leading the league in goals for, the best attack in the league statistically.
Well,
just needs to stay calm. That is a tackle and a half. Determined defending. Weah. It did look on for them, but not to be.
Can the owner of the blue vehicle, registration BG04...
Well, he's lost the ball.
Please return to your vehicle. You've left your lights on. Thank you.
Renato Sanchez. And Renato Sanchez with it now. And dispossessed. I'm hearing that there's been a goal in one of the other matches. Who is it for, Alan McInally?
It's a goal for Peterborough United. 19 minutes played, 1-1.
Thanks very much, as always, Alan. The high press was very much on. And now they have the ball back. Timothy Weah. Oh, he's through here. Can he finish? Our keeper getting both gloves on the ball. Tucker. Ryan Jackson. Well, you've got to keep the ball a bit better than that. Weah. Oh, it might be. And there it is, the breakthrough. That will do nicely.
Well, here it is again. It looks a simple goal. He gets in a position not that far out from goal, but he has to hit the target. He does that, and it's in the back of the net.
1-0 then. Dempsey. Oh, tremendous vision. And teammate, and he's broken free. He read the cross, but now must clatter it clear. James.
As you can see, the visitors haven't had too much of the ball, but to their credit, they've been absolutely blistering on the counter-attack. They just sit...
Oh, surely. Well, really rifling that one in, and he didn't miss by much. Tucker. A goal has been scored in one of the other games. Alan McAnally has the news.
It's a second goal for Peterborough United. 40 minutes played, 2-1.
Alan McAnally keeping us right up to date. They've won back possession. Can they hit on the break? And they'll regard that as a very disappointing end to the move. And in with a real chance. Will he? And it's gone in! The team's separated by two goals now. You cannot say they don't deserve it.
Well, what a time to score. The forwards are in absolute dreamland. The defenders slugging their way back to the half-time team talk. They're not going to enjoy this. Well, there's nothing better for a manager when a plan comes together. Total satisfaction.
So 2-0 now. Well, there is going to be stoppage time, but only the 1 minute. So that is that. The first 45 minutes have come and gone, and it's the visitors on top, Lee.
Well, we know how good their scoring record is, and it's the same...
Plenty to consider based on what we've seen so far. As the second half begins. Makes his way in field. He made it look simple, really. Dempsey. Well, he's got plenty of space on the flank here. Oliver. Oh, that's a pass of high quality. It looked as though he was going to score, but last-ditch defending is something you know about, Lee.
Yeah, he was hassled. It made him hurry his shot, and it's close.
McDonald coming onto the pitch. Number 10, Jordan Graham.
Hadji. Can he finish? A goal! To the good now.
Well, here's the replay. He didn't panic, did he? Decent strike, good technique, bread and butter strike, really, but it's in the back of the net.
So they restart the game, and only one team in it. Graham, well, he has players waiting at the back post. Not to be this time. Half an hour remaining then. I must say, this looks promising. giving them a different option by moving infield. The high press was very much on. Weah. Not the easiest of situations for the keeper. Well, he's given a corner, the referee. Well, I'm hearing there's been a goal in one of the other games. Alan McInally can fill us in.
It's a second goal for Swindon Town. 65 minutes played, 2-2.
Thanks. Oh, big opportunity. Well, on the scent of a hat-trick, but not to be.
Well, how many times in a game do you get a chance to get three goals? Not very often. He'd be kicking himself there.
Ryan Jackson. Well, can they exploit the space out wide? Chances on. Crucial intervention just then amid impending danger. Renato Sanchez at the ready. Fine reaction from the keeper.
Yeah, it looked like a good opportunity to be fair, but the keeper was more than equal to it.
He's got space. An important interception. I believe there's been a goal in one of the other matches. Alan McInally.
It's a goal for Fleetwood Town. 76 minutes played. 1-1.
Regular updates from Alan McInally along the way. Bellingham. Not troubling the keeper. It should be. And there is the goal to make it a hat-trick. Excellence in finishing, there for all to see.
Well, as we look at this again, the keeper's every right to ask where his back line was, but 2v1 in the end, he's thinking now, is he going to pass or go around me? He's got no chance.
Well, if there were any lingering doubts about the outcome, surely they now have been removed. And it's a case of just 5 minutes left. Read it magnificently and intercepted. An incisive pass, and the goalkeeper expertly anticipated that through ball. And if you're wondering about added time, 2 minutes it'll be. Dominic Samuel. And that is that. The referee blows his whistle for full time, and it's a victory for the visitors, Lee.
Well, being potent up front gives you a great chance in any game, and they were certainly that today. Sharp, clinical, and exciting to watch for sure.
And they kick off here. Weah.
Time for just a few questions. Yeah, no further questions, thanks.
Sempre mai so che non sono solo qualcuno.